warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Today you are standing here next to this canal behind me. I am in a city called Yaoundé. It's the capital of Cameroon. Cameroon is a country in nearly West Africa with 30 million people, one of the poorest countries in the world. And the capital of Cameroon is Yaoundé, which has about 4 million people living inside Yaoundé. And the average income monthly is about $60 to $65 a month, and which is very low. And the people who don't have regular income, even $20 a month, they cannot afford it. But what astonished me is what I have seen yesterday after arriving, the heavy rain, which was there for hours and hours and hours. And after the rain stopped, there was no flooding in the main roads in the city center or any other city. Why? Because they built the system as a poor country. They built the system of drainage, getting all the drainage of the rain water coming from this small, you see this small canal coming from the roads to the big canal, which you can see it down there. And all of these will go to the main river, which is called, what's the name of the main river?
Fundi.
The main river called Fundi. So it comes from different streets through these small canals here to go to the main river, the main canal here, and this canal will take the water actually to the Fundi River. What we have seen for the last few days in different parts of the world, especially in the Middle East, rich countries, not often different parts of the Middle East, over the years and over the weeks before, is heavy flooding. Because we don't have this system, we have not built this system inside those Middle Eastern countries. And soon, a drop of water comes from the skies, it blocks roads, it floods the roads, it makes problems, it makes traffic jam, and even sometimes it leads to people dying during the traffic or dying having actually electric shock. This is what we call nowadays, when you compare those countries from this area to a poor country like Cameroon here, this is what we call is corruption. Corruption now is becoming a system, a global system, has its own culture, has its own values, has its own deep states to keep feeding it, let it keep growing and growing and growing and growing, having its own media tycoons and media outlets, have its own elite who can defend this kind of corrupt system, having all these things to keep the corrupt people leading the corrupt state and depriving the people of the state from the resources that Allah has provided them in this area. This is what we see here. When I was here yesterday, when I arrived yesterday from Tanzania, I was shocked with the amount of rain, even in Tanzania as well. It was the same, no flooding in the main roads because the drainage system is there. The canals are there, and you can see it again and again and again. The small hole here is coming from the side road, and the big hole, the big flow of raw water in the canal, and you can see even the water is clean in, and you can see it and going to the Fundu River. As I mentioned, we have the resources, we have the manpower, we have the ability, we have everything, but we have a system which is feeding a system and creating a process of systems to process the system to create corruption. And this is what we have in those so-called rich countries in different parts of the world. When they abuse the resources of the local communities, and instead of spending the resources and on the people, they actually corrupt the people and corrupt the resources and waste the resources. From Cameroon, which is a vital and clear example for us, there was no water on the main roads, on that. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh to everyone everywhere. Here's the second part of my video in Yaoundé, the capital of Cameroon. And here we're talking about the water, the rainwater, the drainage system which has been built in a very poor country like Cameroon. If you compare Cameroon to countries in North Africa, the Middle East, find that they managed to have this drainage system, you can see the canal, gates, one of the crowd bringing gates from one of the side doors, and he will bring gates from this hill up there, and even the small pipe here to bring it more water to come to the same canal, and this will go from there, you can see it there, to go to the bridge. You know, when you look at the cars going there under the bridge, this is the main canal which takes the water. You see the bridge, focus on the bridge there, and underneath it, a huge canal which takes all the rain water to the main river, Kondofondi River, which is about 10 kilometers from here. Here, if we talk about resources, I said no. If we talk about human resources, I mean financial resources, human resources, I said no. It is not financial resources, not human resources, it's a corruption. As I said earlier on, corruption now has become a system. The system has been fed by corrupt people, fed by bad media, fed by bad theologians, fed by all those people who are benefiting from the corrupt deep state within the state itself to stop it. What you have seen in certain countries before is, a few years ago, this flooding and the death of many children and many people and the delay of the traffic for hours, these does not reflect financial resources, lack of financial resources or lack of resources, but this reflects clearly corruption. From Yaoundé, which will be hosting the Africa Cup 2021, the country of Ito, Samuel Ito, to everywhere, from Cameroon. Assalamu alaikum.